إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All thanks and praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek refuge with Allah from our bad deed and our bad action. The one whom Allah guide, no one will misguide. And the one who's misguided, no one will guide. And I bear witness, there is no one worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الفرد الصمد الواحد الأحد and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his messenger and slave, the one whom Allah sent to take the people from the unjust of all the religion to the just of the religion of Islam. إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. Indeed, the best of the speech is the speech of the Quran. The best of the guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The worst of the matters in our religion is the innovation, and each innovation can be a misguide. And each misguide can lead us to the hellfire, وَعَيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك حمدا يملأ السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن. اللهم لك الحمد حمدا حمدا. اللهم لك الحمد أن بلغتنا رمضان. اللهم لك الحمد أن سلمتنا رمضان. قول محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس الخبر كالمعاينة. Our blood محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, telling you something is not like experience the action itself. For example, if I tell you Ramadan is one of the best month in the year, we can talk about it. But experience the month itself is different. فَلَيْسَ الْخَبَرْ كَالْمُعَيْنَ. When you experience the thing yourself, is not like when somebody describes it to you. I can describe the most expensive home here in Miami, and I can show you pictures. But when you walk inside the house and you look through the window, فَلَيْسَ الْخَبَرْ كَالْمُعَيَّنَ. وَلِذَلِكَ قَالَ هِرَقْلٍ لِأَبَا سُفْيَانٍ عِنْدَمَا سَأَلُوا عَنْ أَتْبَاعِ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. When Hiraql asked Abu Sufyan about the people who follow Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, are the elite, the rich people there or the poor people? He said, the poor people. He said, كَذَلِكَ الْأَنْبِيَاء. But then he said, if any one of them turn their back from the deen, from Islam, he said no. He said, كذلك الإيمان إذا خالطت بشاشته القلوب. This is الإيمان. الإيمان, when it hits the heart, nobody can take it away from you. When the feeling of closest to Allah Azza wa Jalla, nobody can take that away from you. That's why the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not turn their back wherever who al-Iman hit their heart. Same story with the magician, Saharat Fir'aun. We all know the story. They were promised money and getting closer to Fir'aun. In a split of a second, they totally changed. قالوا لن نؤثرك على ما جاءنا من البينات والذي فطرنا فاقض ما أنت قاض إنما تقضي هذه الحياة الدنيا. We're not gonna put you as a priority, on top of our priority right now, which is the deed. Immediately, as soon as they saw that wasn't a magic, what Moses coming with is not. So the Iman hit their hearts immediately. So no more scared of Fir'aun. No more worry about what they're going to lose. As each one of us in this dunya, we have our priorities, but maybe the deen will come in the end. But they put the deen as first. لَن نُؤْثِرَكَ عَلَى مَا جَاءَ مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالَّذِي فَطَرَنَا. We're not going to put you on top of that. immediately iman hit their hearts. فَقْضِ مَا أَنْتَ قَاضٍ. Do whatever you want to do. هكذا الإيمان. This is when the iman. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ذاق حلاوة الإيمان أو ذاق طعم الإيمان من رضي بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا. Hey, taste. That's not just what you taste the food when you break your fast. There is a taste of the iman too as well. And that's what Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said. ذاق حلاوة طعم الإيمان. You will taste the iman as soon as you believe in Allah عز وجل. You satisfied with Allah. رضي بالله ربا. Allah is my Lord عز وجل. And Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is my messenger. And Islam is my deen. What does that mean? I follow. Not just by the tongue. When I say Allah is my Lord, Rabbi Allah, then what Allah wants me to do, and I follow. When I say Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his messenger, what is his life? What do I know about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And you accept your deen, as that's the last message was sent to all mankind. فهذه حلاوة. ثلاث من كنا فيه ذاق حلاوة الإيمان. Three kind of thing. If you will have it, you'll taste. So إذن للإيمان طعم ومذاق. وفي حديث طلحة بن عبيد الله وصححه الألباني. This hadith about طلحة. And this is amazing hadith that he said he used to have two of his friends. They both became Muslim at the same time. And both make hijrah at the same time to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they both went to jihad at the same time. Became Muslim together, make hijrah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam together, went to fight for the sake of Allah azza wa jal together. فَمَاتَ أَحَدٌ. One of them died. وَعَاشَ الْآخَرْ بَعْدَهُ بِعَدْ. أو كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And that one died in the battlefield, and the other one lived for another year. فَطَلْحَ had a dream. And what kind of dream the people who's closer to Allah have? He dreamt he was in the door of the Jannah, standing in the door of Jannah. What kind of dream do we have? You know, when you have your heart get attached to Allah Azza wa Jal, your dream will be a little bit different. Will get to be attached to your deen. So he said, I had a dream that we all three were standing on the door of Jannah. فَجَاءَ مُنَادِي. Somebody called and came, and he called for the second one. The one who died a year later. And we all know the reward of the jihad. I mean, jihad, we even have to watch the shaheed. Shaheed with the first blood comes out, it's forgiven. That's it. In the highest level of Jannah. It's a hadith about fadl al-jihad. فَطَلْحَ find this is strange. The one who died is a murderer. And they both did everything together. How come he's been called? He's not being called and the other one is being called. And after a while, جاء منادي ونادى من مات في الجهاد. And then after a while they came and they called the first one. And then they came to Talha and said, ليس بعد. Not yet. So he wake up from his dream, find it strange, and went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him, what's going on? We know about the jihad and fadl al-jihad and on and on. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم ألم يعش بعده عام. Did he live after him 1 year? He said, yes. وَأَدْرَكَ رَمَضَانَ. Did he witness Ramadan? He said, yes. He said, وَرَقَعَ كَذَا وَسَجَدَ كَذَا. Did he pray this and make this ruku and this number of sujood? They said, yes. قَالَ إِذَا مَا بَيْنَهُمَا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. What's the level between both of them is between what's the earth and the heaven. Just because he witnessed Ramadan after the one who was died in the battlefield. فَسُبْحَانَ فضل رمضان عظيم عظيم. I mean, I don't know, as we start ليس الخبر كالمعاين. We can talk about Ramadan, but now we experience. اللهم لك الحمد. أنت يعني عشان تحس بالنعمة, to feel the blessing, if you don't have this blessing, imagine you're not witnessing Ramadan. Imagine the people who died, they're not with us now witnessing Ramadan. And imagine some people are sick, they cannot fast. Or on and on and on. Allah bless you that you witnessed this month. And Allah knows. لعله آخر رمضان. Who knows? Maybe it's the last Ramadan. Nobody can guarantee. فسبحان الله. فبيكوز اوف رمضان شهر عظيم. انت بتسمع كلام الله عز وجل كل يوم. When you come to the masajid and you pray Tarawih, what are you listening to? What first of all, which house are you in? It's the house of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Which you feel more comfortable in it than your own house. There's no question asked. What you hear the words of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Ayah, if you reflect in one ayah, just one ayah, it hits your heart. You got it. So هذا شهر عظيم. شهر عظيم سبحان. That's why you ask the people who goes to Hajj or people go to Umrah and they come back. And we experience it. And we know some brother here, mashallah, they went with Hajj with us. I mean, throughout the process of Hajj, of course, it's a hard time, tough time. You see some brother complain, whatever. But in the airport, what they're doing, they're crying. Why are you crying? I don't want to leave. After all this hard time that they face, because they felt something in the heart. They disconnect from everything. That's what we need. We need to disconnect. I mean, we are like rats. It's a cycle. Circle, we're just going in every day, in and out. Wake up, go to work, or do your schooling, and then where is Allah from all that? So Ramadan comes and tells you, hold, put a break a little bit. Look how much time you give to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Ajeeb. And outside Ramadan, maybe we hardly can come to the masjid just to pray with the jama'ah. Right? But mashallah, now with the time of the tarawih, people come and pray, you make the time, you fast the whole day. This is the message. Allah wants to tell you, you have this time every day, we all equal in it. What are you going to do? What are you going to get closer to Allah? So that's why you see people before the month, they excite. See people, they cry in the end of the month, that the month will be gone. God knows, as we said, if we're going to witness it or not. فسبحانه. فيعني, getting closer to Allah Azza wa Jal in this month, this opportunity doesn't come every day. When you see, like I said, the people, when they feel getting closer to Allah Azza wa Jal, فسبحانه, some of us will say, brothers, I'm so far away from Allah Azza wa Jal. I have sins, I'm doing this, I'm committing this, I'm too far away. We say, subhanahu wa فَمَا ظَنُّكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. What do you think about Allah Azza wa Jal, the most merciful, Azza wa Jal? يعني, even though when you read the Sahaba, the seer of the Sahaba, the one who killed 99 persons. 99. Anyone here killed 99? No one. Subhanallah, hadith sahih. He immediately, as soon as he repented, his heart went back to Allah Azza wa Jal. And immediately he got the right advice from the right knowledgeable scholar. Then he left the place that he was in, the town that he was committed all this, nobody stopped him in it. So the advice, leave that place. And that's a reminder for us too as well. When you see yourself going away from Allah Azza wa Jal, who are you surrounding yourself with? Who are you around? Look and stay away. Because they're just going to drag you down. So immediately the advice, leave that place. He left it. But in a way, angel of death came to take his soul. So now the angel of ملائكة العذاب وملائكة الرحمة يتخاصمون عليه. The angel of the mercy and the angel of the hellfire, they find over him. Is he going to go to the hellfire or he's going to go to Jannah? He killed 99 persons. As a matter of fact, 100, because when he went to the other scholar, he wasn't alim, he was just sa'abid. And that's the difference with the ilm. That's the difference with knowledge and deen. He told him, no, Allah will not forgive you. So he finished 100, right? But now in the middle of the road, he was already in the middle of it. So Allah Azza wa Jal ordered the earth to shrink a little bit and get him closer to the new town. Because they said, Allah sent one to be a judge with them. He said, if he's closer to the new land, he goes to Jannah. And if he's closer to the old one, he goes to the hellfire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the earth to get him a little bit closer. هذا هو الرحيم. هذا هو الله عز وجل. This Allah, so no matter what you do, you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Khalid ibn Walid, before he became Muslim, what did he do in Uhud? Then he became Saifullah Muslim. Right? Sahab. So when we think about ourselves, getting to this month, and you want to repent, don't lose hope with Allah Azza wa Jal. Don't lose hope with Allah Azza wa Jal. Rahmatu wasa'at kulli shay. Rahmatullah wasa'at kulli shay. قولوا قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله وكفى الصلاة والسلام على من اصطفى. We want to take advantage of this month, and the doors are unlocked. We're not going to ask you to do like Al-Bukhari or maybe Shafi'i that they used to finish the Quran 60 times in Ramadan, right? We're not going to be asked to do that, right? There is a call to action. As a matter of fact, it was just released about a month ago. A lady, an old lady in Egypt, mashallah, she finished the Quran once every day. She wake up in the morning, after Fajr, until Isha. Even though when they were interviewing her, she had the Quran in front of her. And she was reading. She made khatma once a day. So it's not like, oh, I cannot believe it. No, it happened. When we said, Uthman stood and he read the Quran one rak'ah, because these people did not sit on their feet. They sit on their heart. They tasted the iman. They knew who Allah Azza wa Jalla. And they felt it. And when they felt it, nothing really was equal to them. When Uthman comes and spend everything for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, this is the love for Allah Azza wa Jal. Nothing else. Nothing else. So, you gotta think, what I'm gonna do? Time is gone. Today's what, the 11th, the 12th? The month is gonna be gone before we know. So, where are you at? What's your schedule? What have you done? It's like that. I'm gonna read the Quran. Reflect on the Quran. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make qiyam with one ayah. Into adimu fa innam ibad. Tafullah wa nakatah. Yani, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make qiyam with one ayah. So inta, as we said, if you reflect on one ayah, bring an ayah from the Quran, find the tafsir, 2, 3, 4 tafsir from the Quran, understand it, and see what's going to happen to your heart. This is the word of Allah Azza wa Jalla. You have 6,600 ayah in the Quran. That's the Quran. People, mashallah, memorize the Quran. That's a blessing. In the highest place in Jannah, mashallah, people will memorize the Quran. May Allah give them the thabat. It's a goal. Go just make the intention for it. It's not hard. You, mashallah, you memorize so many things. You know, you went through your whole schooling and everything else. But just make the intention. Make the intention. And start with the short surah if you want. And understanding the meaning of it. Right? Just deal with the Quran in a different way. Instead of it's in the show. And then when the month comes, I might open it and then I'll leave it behind. No, we want to go higher. I mean, الناس في أشد الحاجة إلينا. يعني, the whole world, it's in a dire need for real, true Muslims. Brothers, it's bad up there. And wallahi, الذي لا إله إلا هو إحنا, we have a big responsibility in our shoulder to everybody, non-Muslim before Muslims. But we don't know what we have. Absolutely, we don't know the value of what we have. We don't know the value of the Quran and the deen. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I did not create the jinn or ins except for ibadah. And you have people lived for 70, 80 years and they never make rak'ah to Allah Azza wa Jal or sujood. And then you'll say, well, I'm alive. I have my job. I have my money in the bank. I eat. I drink. I have my family. It's good. No, it's not good. It's not good. And if we are the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we're going to look at it a different way. The whole world is going into that direction. And we see it in front of us. And the only solution for them is Islam. It is. There is no if and buts about it. The only solution for them is Islam. The message that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. So where are we with this? So when a month comes like this, to bring us closer to Allah Azza wa Jal, and make us realize why we are here for, and we're still getting busy with something else. We don't know what's going to come and remind us with Allah Azza wa Jal. I don't know. I don't know what other month will come and will get us closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. If we take in this month as a habit, I'm just going to get up, just fast, then break my fast, and then maybe after Taraweeh I go watch the shows. Allah yuridu an yatubu alayhi. Wa yuridu alladhina yattabi'una shahawati an tamilu maylan adhima. Allah wants you to repent. And everybody else, they want you to go away from Allah. Haven't you witnessed, and I guess not just maybe in the Middle East, I guess maybe also in Pakistan and India and Bangladesh, I guess the TV is the top in Ramadan. Top shows. Haven't you think about it? Didn't even realize that? These people want your heart. They want your attention to be away from Allah Azza wa Jal. So they come in that specific month, that the month that you're supposed to be closer to Allah, and they want to take you away. Not just that, the food too. SubhanAllah, it's the month of fasting, and all we worry about is the food. Ajeeb. Strange. Worry about our wife, and maybe we'll get upset with them if they're not cooking what we want. Yeah, SubhanAllah. And this is supposed to be the month of fasting. تغيرت المعايير. And that's the work of the shaitan and the work of the enemy of the Muslims. They have been doing it for the past 100 years since the fall of the Khilafah. نسأل الله أن تكون خلافة كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث حديث صحيح يسد خلاف على منهاج النبوة. It will be a خلاف. The Islam will rule again as it ruled before with just and go read in the books and go see the Jewish when they were in Andalus in Spain and who saved them there from the crusade. It's been written in the book when they went to the Morocco. Why Morocco has a lot of Jewish there? Because we are the one who saved. We are the one who took them in the boat and we took them there. This is Islam. This is Islam. Everybody knows what Islam stands for. But the people of the unjust, they want to fight that. So unfortunately, the thing that you feel sorry about you as a Muslim, you can be fallen under them. And you just be used like that. This is the month that we get closer. So Quran, getting closer to Allah Azza. This is the word of Allah Azza wa Jal. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana ajwad al-nas fi Ramadan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kareem, generous in Ramadan. How much did we give so far since the beginning of Ramadan? Isn't it a different month for us? Did we start giving or no? And if you're not going to give in this month, when are you going to give? Right? And maybe your time is more important than the money in your pocket, the dollar or $1,000 in your pocket. Your time is more important. Are you giving time for the deen? Right? Akana ajwad al-nas sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to give. Without stop. So subhanAllah, yani Quran, charity, getting involved. Just go back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Go back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And you want this heart at this time to be attached to Arsh al-Rahman. Man aqrab, man, yani, who's in the highest level of Jannah? Who? Jannah al-Firdaus. Firdaus al-A'la. This is the highest level of Jannah. Why? Why is that? Because of the Hur al-Ain, because of the rivers, because of all the, you know, what Allah will bless us there in Jannah? No. Because this is the closest place to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Al-Firdaus Arsh, يعني الزقف, زقفه هو عرش الرحمن. The ceiling of Al-Firdaus Al-A'la is the throne of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So you are in the closest place to Allah Azza wa Jalla. فأسعد الناس في الجنة هم أقربهم إلى الله Azza wa Jalla. So the most happiest people in Jannah, the one who is closer to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Right? أصحاب اليمين ما أصحاب اليمين. أصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال. والسابقون السابقون أولئك المقربون في جنات النعيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah he said, yeah, the people of the right is going to be there, the people of the left like that, and people going ahead of it. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says أولئك المقربون, they are the nearest one. Before he said they are in Jannah. فقدم التقرب على الجنه. فالله سبحانه وتعالى says they're going to be near Allah Azza wa Jalla more than being in Jannah. So this is the real happiness, being closer to Allah Azza wa Jalla. امرأة فرعون, the wife of Fir'aun, what did she ask? قالت رب ابن لي عندك بيتا في الجنة. She asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اختارت الجار قبل الدار. She asked for the neighbor before the Jannah. Oh Allah, I want to be near you first, before I want to be in Jannah. I want to be near you, be than Jannah. فأسعد الناس في الجنة هم أقربهم إلى الله عز وجل. The most happiest people in Jannah is the one who's closer to Allah. So who's the most happiest in this dunya? The one who's closer to Allah Azza wa Jalla. There's no question asked. There's no question. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, and we'll finish with this. مَنْ كَانَتِ الْآخِرَةُ هَمُّ جَعَلُ اللَّهُ غِنَاهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ وَجَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ شَمْهِ وَأَتَتْهُ الدُّنْيَا وَهِرَاهُ. The one who's going to think about الْآخِرَةُ, meaning thinking about the day that you're going to meet Allah, you're going to see Allah Azza wa Jalla, you're thinking about Allah. So what's going to happen? جَعَلُ اللَّهُ غِنَاهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ. This is the happiness. Allah will make you happy. And a lot of us maybe experience that. It's not about the money, it's not about this. It's just certain happiness. Allah can give you satisfaction, rida. You are satisfied with what Allah gave you. Not everybody has that. It's only Allah Azza wa Jal can put that in your heart. مَنْ كَانَتِ الْآخِرَةُ هَمُّ جَعْلُ اللَّهُ غِنَاهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ وَجَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ شَمْهِ. All your affair that you are worried about, Allah will gather it for you. Always, always. You don't have to be running all over the place. No, the affair is being solved around you. Just because you attach this heart to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And whatever is going to come from the dunya is going to come while you honor Muslim, honor, izzah. You're not running after it. You're not selling your deen cheap to get something out of it. And on the other hand, in the hadith, the one who's worried about this dunya,
ده سبحان الله خلاص
جعل الله فقره بين عينينا. Always, it's not enough. It's not enough. No matter what you have, it's not enough. You got your nice house that you want, while you see somebody else's bigger home, this is better house than mine. You got the nice clothes that you were dying to buy, you wear it once, twice, you throw it in a closet, and you're waiting for another clothes. That's life. That's life. The only one can take care of that, Allah Azza wa Jalla. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to attach this heart to Him Azza wa Jalla. So if one goal, just one goal, what do you want from Ramadan? We should ask ourselves, what do we want from Ramadan? What do you need from Ramadan before Ramadan is over? To get this heart attached to Allah Azza wa Jalla. To get this heart attached to Allah Azza wa Jalla. If this heart get attached to Allah Azza wa Jalla, nobody will take you away after Ramadan. You're not gonna go back to your old habits after Ramadan. You're gonna stay because ستذوق حلاوة الإيمان. You're gonna taste the sweetness of Iman. That's it, bottom line. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يسلمنا رمضان ويتسلم رمضان منا ويسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى that he give us رمضان that he take it from us and accept it from us. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت واعف واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت إنك سبحانك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك. اللهم يا واصل المقطعين صلنا إليك. اللهم يا واصل المقطعين صلنا إليك. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم انا نسألك من خير ما سألك به عبدك ونبيك محمد. نعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك به عبدك ونبيك محمد. اللهم انا نسألك الخير كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. جزاكم الله خير. Just a quick announcement that inshallah the pharmacy with brother Ramzi at 8540 North Kendall Drive, 8540 North Kendall Drive. Inshallah, he's gonna have the shot tomorrow, inshallah, between 10 and 2 p.m. Right? 10 and 2 p.m. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum.